Good morning, all of you. So, as we have started the concept of linked list, so today we would continue with the same concept of circular linked list and a double linked list. As you know, as I had a discussion with a few of the members of the class, so you need a few of the tracing from the hand or the on the whiteboard. So maybe I'm planning for it so that you understand the concept. Let us think about it. That is, you want me to trace or write the program or to explain with the hand. So let us see that I'm looking for a hardware so that I can show you the tracing by writing on the whiteboard as such. So before that, today we'll see the concept of a circular linked list and a double linked list. So basically, those who have still you have not followed the knowledge of what exactly the linked list is, so for them, just for the time sake, I would like to show you one of the animation video when you can understand the concepts easily. So you could see here I have to arrange the students. Okay, we need to arrange the list of the students according to the first letter. So this is just think with respect to the array and the data structures. Okay, so we'll arrange in ascending order. So this is one of the concept wherein we can arrange this in ascending order, right? Just think of how it occupies the memory, right? So we have arranged in sequential order, right? These are all the names, logical of the concept. So we are arranged in ascending order in the memory. There are two ways. That is, one is by using a array. So another method is, one of the method is using the linked list. Okay. So by using this, we can maintain the store these things into the memory. Like array uses the concept of indexing A of 0, 1, 2, 3. The linked list uses the concepts of node and the address. So you could see a few of the limitations. So what could be the limitations? So you have seen the limitations. Let me not go with the limitations, right? So in single list, there are a few of the drawbacks also. The navigation is that from left to right only, right? Whereas in the case of double linked list, so you have forward, that is the thing that we are going to see today. So we can have forward and backward navigations. So circular list, yesterday, the last class, just we started in that. Last element is always linked to the first element, that is in a circular way. So that is, last elements holds the address of the first element. So that we are going to see. So this, at the beginning, you know what is a linked list. It consists of two nodes, data and link. Okay, let me forward. See, data is nothing but a pure data, the value that is stored in the variable. Link is nothing but it is the address of the another variable. And one question was being asked, what about the first node? First node will have an address. Okay, so but it doesn't holds the first node doesn't holds the address of its own. The address is outside the first or the head. Head contains the direct address. Suppose you want to store a list of numbers, this. So you see how it is being stored. So these are the values. Now, outside I have written 1000. No, this 1000 is nothing but this is a head. This 1000, no, this 1000 is nothing but the head. So this is what being given, shown to you. That is 1000 as a head or the first inbox. This is being addressed over here. What we do, always we make a copy of, no, that is, we do, we take a temp. Just for a second. Okay, what do we do? You remember, what do we do is always, so what we have done previously is, so instead of making this 1000, again we'll make this copy as a copy and we make this point it as a temp. So there are two copies. So this is for the purpose of insertion, deletion, or creating of a node. or insertion at any at the front end or the rear end. So all together in all the cases of single linked list, double linked list or circular list, the concept is same. Initialize, you have to take the variable call temp and you have to copy the same address of the first node, and this is one and the same, this 1000 and temp, no, this is start or head, somewhere it has used start as first. So this first always holds the address of the first node, got it? It holds the address of the first node. So for example, if I say the simple last class, I said house number 1000 means it will visit this node. House number similarly 2000 means it will visit this node. But what is the connectivity? The connectivity is, let us see, the connectivity of house number 1000, what it contains, the per people called, person called 23, and what is the subordinate neighboring hood. So that is it is connected to the link called 2000. So that we have to see. So what you could see over here is, see, the address 54 is the node 54 is being connected to the, so this is the first address. So 2000 3000 as such. So what do we do is, so what do? We simply copy the address 2000 so that the link is being connected from here to here. So this is what the concept. This is for the beginners who are right now there into the concept. So for them, I am explaining. This is what I had explained. So this is made as a head or a start. And one more copy is temp is made in order to perform various operations. Okay. So let me, those who have not followed, please try to focus on this and do it. Okay. So next, what we do is, so same concept. So all together in the circular queue or the double linked list or a single linked list, we have the same concept to be followed. So as I said, from first, before we go to the programming, it is highly important for us to understand the graphical representation. So if you have that graphical representation in your mind, you find it easy to understand the concepts. So let me today again, once again, with the circular and double linked list, only simple concept I'll teach. I'll not go with a complex concept. Okay. So, and hardly the part of the code, step by step, I would like to explain. And maybe I'm looking for a hardware, as I said, so that I can write it on the whiteboard and show it, display it on to you, so that you understand the concept of understanding. So still, I'm trying to annotate it so that you should not find it difficult, right? So now here, see, this is a circular linked list. What is the advantage? What is the basic happening in a circular linked list is, always a circular linked list holds the address, the last node. So this is the first node, this is the last node. The last node holds the address of the first node. So where is the address of the first node? Address of the first node is here. Okay. So maybe if I write 100 as such, 100 is the address of first node. Clear? 100 is the address of first node. And what it contains, it holds the address of the second node. This holds the address of third node, that is 45. 10th, house number 10, its address is folded in 45. Similarly, 80 is its address is holding address. So when I say address, so you address is being above, it is written above. This address is written above. This address is written above. This address is written above. And this is direct as 100. Whereas this 100 is over here. This 100 is over here. So circular list is as such. So what is the address of first node? Okay, it is 100. Where it is being written? It is written in the first, that points to the first node. The same address is being copied in the last node. So last node, after last node 80, who is the subordinate? go to the address number 100. Where is 100? 100 goes to the here. It points to the first node. This itself is a concept, right? With these concepts, we need to proceed further for insertion, deletion as such. So what all the various operations could be performed, right? Hopefully you have followed. So there are two approaches, okay? There are two approaches. That is, either by using the address that is being denoted at the first node. First contains what? Address of the first node. Similarly, we have one more called last. What does the last holds? Okay, last holds the address of this only. Last holds the address of the last node. Whereas this compartment, see, there are two things here. Last node holds the address of this node. So, and this one is common. Remember, for example, this is 200. Imagine 200. Go to the address 200 means what? Go to the address 200. So its address is 200. So either I can write 200 above, or either I can write the last address is 200. Try to understand. If you understand this concept, you find it easy. Say I write in the box called 200 last, I have written 200. And what about this node? This last node holds the address of the first node. What is the address of first node? Maybe it is 100. Either by using first, you could denote. So it is above the node. So 100. So 100 is above here. So this is a concept of circular list. In the circular list, last node holds the address of the first node. So what is the address of first node? 100 is the address of first node. And what is last? Last contains the address of the last node. So what is the address of last node? So I have written 200, no? So 200 is inside this. Is this? And what about the address of 10? It says that go to the house number 200. Where is the house number 200? It is over here, right? Clear? So once again, the last node holds the address of the first node. Last node, node means this. Last node holds the address of the first node. And last, the variable last holds the address of the last node. Address of last node, the variable. I say the variable last holds the address of the last node. Where is the address of the last node? It is above address 200, right? So this is a way. Let us proceed further now to the other concept, that is any sort of what all the operations that could be performed. So I'll not take I'll not make the job complex. Let us go very simpler manner. So, and what I'll plan is maybe I'll start stacks and queues tomorrow's class, and I will take these concepts immediately after completing stacks and queues, because I could find a few of the feedback personally from few of the people, from the students, that if they're finding it difficult with respect to the data structure, especially the concept of a linked list. So I prefer you. Let us go to the stacks and queues and other concepts. Let us come to these concepts. Anyway, to one extent, we have covered few of the concept. Now, the concept is insert at the front, insert at the rear. Same, delete at the front, delete at the rear in the circular list and the display. So let us go with a simple one concept, that is insert the node at the front end. How to insert an element at the front end of the list. Okay, so here is the concept. See. Try to analyze the diagram. So what is the what do we have in the diagram? Very simple. See, already we have the last node holds the address of the second node. Is it or not? See, let me write it. If you have not understood, I'll write 100 address of the first node. So it is being written above as a first. Okay, house number 100 is here, it contains 20. Similarly, the address of the last node is, so let me write 200 either in the box or either above. So this is written inside the box. Last address of the last node is 200. Address of the last node is 200. What is the link of the last node? It is 100. Link is different. This is a last node. Okay, this is address of the last node. try to understand the words. Address of last node is this above. Node means contains two variables, right? Node means last node contains number 80 and address of the next node. Address of the next node is 100. What is this address? It is 100 as such. Hopefully able to understand. Now what we'll do, this is 200, right? So again, this compartment also contains 200 now. That is, this is a node that contains value 10. Where I have to go? You go to the house number 200. So 200, where we have? We have here, right? Now, the concept is insert at the front. That is, you have one of the node called new node called temp. You create a new node called temp. Temp should contain a value called 50 and it should hold the address of the next node. So this is the dotted lines is the imagination that we are going to do. So how do you do it? Because when you insert a first node, see here, try to understand, when you insert a first node called 50, 20 will become a second node. 20 will become a second node. So what we have to do, first create a node called temp, store the value called 50, right? And what you have to do, see, you have to disconnect this link. What is this link? The last node holds the address of the first node, that you have to disconnect, and you should make sure that last node should holds the address of the temp of link. What is temp of link? See here, the address temp, right? Once again, let us go with the concept. Those who have joined, just concentrate. This, I started a circular link list. Okay, let it be here only, or else you'll get confused. This is 200 only. Let it be like this only. Okay. Now see what is being happening. In the first step, you create a variable called temp and store value 50. Store value 50. Then what you are going to do? So you're unqualifying this and you're making the last address of, that is, this is link, no, address of last node to the temp, assigning into the temp. So first you create a node, right? You copy the item 50 into the temp of information. So temp consists of temp of information, temp of link. See, it consists of temp of information, temp of link. Temp of information, temp of information is this, temp of link is this. So first malloc temp one struct node. So you are creating a node by the name called temp, right? Then you're copying to the temp of information the item. Item contains the value called 50. Next, immediately what we'll do, to the temp of link, to the temp of link, you copy the last of link. See here, what is last of link here? Last of link is here, no? Last of link is here. Last of link is here. You're copying this to the temp of link. What is temp of link? Here. Once again, those have not followed. See here, previously, okay, so let me go with this value only. So what was the address of this link? It was 100, no? What was the address of this link? It was 200. So what we have to do, the last link was 200. So disconnect it, this 200, and it contains 100. So what I have to do, you disconnect this, that is last link with the 20 connecting, you disconnect last of link 100 is assigned to temp of link. Temp of link is it or not? You assign this to the temp of link. Last of link, you copy. See, you always read the assignment operator like this. Last of link is copied to the temp of link. After copying this information, you are going to this temp of information filled with 50, then last of link. So just all of you concentrate. So you read assignment operator like this. Okay, what is last of link? Last of link holds the address of the first node. Is it or not? So last of link holds the address of the first link. Now what we'll do? We'll reassign last of link. This will be copied instead of pointing to here to the address of the temp of link. Now it is pointing over here. Got it? Once again, I repeat. See, previously the last of link was assigned to the this node. First of link. Okay. Now, what I'll do? Last of link was reassigned to the temp of link. So it is assigned over here. Simply copy the address of the first node. That is last of link. It is available in the last node to the newly obtained temp. By following this statement, it will copy the last node's address directly to the temp of the address. Then we have to copy one more thing. What about the first link that you have created? This temp of link, temp, you copy the address. You copy temp, that is a newly taken value, as a last of link. Is it or not? You have to reassign. See, these two statements are too important for you. Two statements are very important for you. So this is quite easy. That is creating a node, copying the item to the temp of information. Since temp of link has to be also filled with what? Address of the last link. So last of link was copied to the temp of link. Then what you do? You have to establish the link between the node temp and the last node. This is achieved by copying the address of the node temp into the link field of the node last. Okay, copy temp into last of link. You are copying temp value into last of link. So this you are going to put it over here. First, create this node, store 50 to it. So reassign. Previously, last of link was pointing to the first of link. No, let's point to first of link. Now what we'll do? Point this last of link to the dotted lines temp of link. So now it is pointing over to the here. So by following those statements, then again, what you have to do? You have to copy temp of address. No, previously it holds the 80. This compartment holds the address of 20. So now I have to reassign. No, since because you have changed the link, so this address has to be copied. What is that? Temp. So copy temp into the last of link. And this holds what? The address of the this node, obviously. Address of this node. So let me go to the code now. So create a node by the name malloc. Copy the last of link with temp of link and store the value temp to the last of link. Then finally, we have to, what we have to do, we have to return the address of the last node using the statement called return last, right? So in the programming wise, see the same statement, create a node to be inserted, make temp as the first node, right? First, whether you have to verify whether the stack is empty or not. This is the normal statement always we have to see. No, it is not empty. Then what you do, you copy the last of link, that is you are going to insert at the front, last link, last of link, reassigning as the temp of link, then copy the temp into the last of link. So similarly, at the rear end, you have to follow the same concept of temp. Here, see, in this case, what happens? We create the disconnectivity. So there is a correction. This is a 10, okay? This is 10. Now see here, at the last, you are going to insert the number 80. So what you are going to do, you are going to create one variable called temp. You have to update the data of temp, that is copy 80 here. Then see, you have to make the disconnectivity, that is instead of last of link assigning to the first of link. So what you are going to do, you are going to assign temp of link to the first of link. So that, how do you do? See here, first, last of link, first create this, copy the item. So last of link is copied to the temp of link. So last of link, so this was last, no, previously last of link was copied to the temp of link. Now the temp of link becomes the simple, see, second operation. This is last, this is last. What is last of link? Last of link is this. Last of link means this. This you copy to the temp of link. Okay. This address will be copied over here. Able to understand, this address is going to, last of link is going to copy to the temp of link. After that, what do you do? After that, what do you do? You assign temp as last of link. You assign temp. This temp, no? As last of link. See, hopefully able to understand. See, now you are able to understand. You're going to copy temp. So you copy it from this to this, last of link to the temp of link. So once you copy last of link to the temp of link, this is empty, no? When you transfer from your direction, see, last of link was copied to the temp of link. This copy, this is now empty. Now this is empty. Now what you have to do? Copy temp reverse to the last of link. See the direction, see my directions. Copy the temp, step C, copy the temp to the last of link. So finally, we have to return temp. The new node is made up as the last node using this statement. Hence, you have to return the last, return last, return temp as such. So as of now, maybe you can focus. I have forwarded this PDF files into the Google Classroom. All of you just focus, try to understand. You need not to panic about these data structures, especially the single list, circular list, and double linked list. So let me have some confidence on you. Let me put sweet confidence. So maybe I have planned to switch over to the stacks and queues so that you should not have a kind of discouragement what you are feeling in this concept, especially with respect to the linked list. Let us analyze it properly once again. So I request you to give the attendance as of now. So let me have certain planning for it so that you should not lose a confidence into the concept of data structure, especially the linked list concept. Okay. So those have not understood, still inserting the node at the end. Try to understand once again. See, what we are going to do is we are going to create a node called a temp, and we are going to store a value called temp of information equals to 80, right? Now, what should be the temp of link should contains? Temp of link should contain the address of the first node, no? But address of the first node is where it is. Address of the first node is here. Try to understand once again. Address of the first node is here, no? Because last node holds the address of first node in circular linked list. This holds the address of the first node. But since this is not the last node, since this is not the last node is different, last is different. Since last node, so what I have to do? I have to copy this. That is last of link should be copied to the, see the movement, to the temp of link. Now I copied. Now it became empty, no? This should contains what? This should contains, this is address, no? Temp means the address. Temp means a variable which holds the address, and it have a value called temp of information 80. Temp of link was empty. I filled with this address. Why? Because this was holding the first address. No, this address was being copied. Now the connectivity happens from when I say last of, that is temp of link was connected to the automatically to the this address. When I copy automatically, it will connect, right? Then what I have to do, this becomes empty. No, this has to be filled with the temp, that is last of link should be filled with the temp. So this is what the concept is. See, last of link should be copied to the temp of link, this statement. Next, copy temp to the last of link. So able to understand. So let us cover these concepts. Let us do a planning. I'm really but you know, worried how to convince the concepts. So let us try to work it out. So if possible, maybe we'll start tomorrow with the stacks and queues. If not possible, I'll continue the same concept, or else stacks and queues are quite easy compared to this. So let us see what we could do today, and we can think. I forwarded this concept in your Google Classroom. I request all of you to go through once in the Google Classroom, download it. So I have saved by linked list one, linked list two. All of you try to go through, at least you get a confidence to write it in the examination. What is first link, last link as such? Okay. So now today we'll stop as for the session. So I'll try to take, we'll take a class tomorrow. Those who are not given the attendance can give the attendance on the chat session. You can give the attendance in the chat session.